guys, it's Jen. Recently, I hit 500,000 subscribers on YouTube, which is insane. So I decided that in honor of 500,000 subscribers, I would tell you guys my YouTube story. I'm kind of just going into this video with no real preparation, just saying exactly what I'm thinking, so if it's a little bit jumbled around, I apologize, but let's get started. I've had a passion for making videos and making other people laugh for as long as I can remember. When I was younger, I used to put on comedy shows in my house, and I'd give out tickets to my family members in the beginning of the day, block off the living room, and then at the end of the day, I would charge my family members the ticket to get in, and I'd tell jokes. I got the jokes out of a SpongeBob joke book, and they probably weren't even that funny, but regardless, my parents supported me wholeheartedly. Then, one day, I was going through this little chest that we have in our house, and I found a video camera. I played around with it for hours, recording literally everything. Eventually, I started making short films by myself and with some of my really good friends. But I had a problem. I didn't really have anyone to share the movies that I made with. So, I did the same thing I did with the little comedy shows, except I turned my living room into a movie theater. Until one day, I came across this website called YouTube. And I actually remember the first video that I ever saw on YouTube, which is a video called Spider-Man, Spider-Man by Smosh. I was obsessed, and I had found other people who loved to do the same exact thing that I did. So, a little while later, I got together with one of my best friends at the time, and we decided to make a channel together in hopes of being the girl version of Smosh. We made a couple of really funny videos together, but she got really into singing, and then our channel just slowly came to a stop. A couple months later, that summer, I decided to branch off and make my own channel, JenXPen, and I started making videos by myself, but in secret. I only told my close friends, and I was even reluctant to tell them because I was just kind of anxious to see what they would think about it. But of course, eventually word got around my school that I made videos on the internet, and a lot of people didn't take it too well at first. I got a lot of people picking on me because they either thought I was weird, or my videos were bad, or I was dumb, just a lot of negativity towards it. But regardless, I ignored what people said, and I went on with it anyway, and that winter, me and a couple friends that I made online decided to start a collab channel together. My collab. And this collab channel had gotten me a good amount of exposure, and what do you know, the people in my school started warming up to me about my videos a little more. Around the beginning of 2011, I decided that I wanted to save up for a new camera. While most of the kids my age were saving up their money to buy clothes or candy or whatever teenage kids buy, I was saving my money to buy a camera. Finally, in the winter of 2011, I had saved up enough money to buy the camera that I wanted, a Canon 60D, and it was one of the most exciting things of my life. I'm not sure how many of you guys have ever made a big purchase before, but the experience of saving up money for such a long time and then finally getting what you were saving up for is just one of the most gratifying things ever. That summer, I went to my first ever YouTube event, VidCon. VidCon was one of the most surreal experiences of my entire life. Getting to meet some of my favorite YouTubers who I've only seen on a screen was one of the coolest and weirdest things ever. And VidCon had really, really inspired me to keep going with my YouTube because it made me realize how real YouTube actually is. A lot of times when you post YouTube videos and you see the amount of viewers or the amount of comments, it doesn't really hit you that there's a real person behind that number. And going to a YouTube event completely changes the way you look at that. Soon, I started working with a company called Awesomeness TV, and I think that's where everything changed. I started getting flown out to the other side of the country, California, a place I've never been to before, all because of YouTube. And while I was out there, I got to hang out with the friends that I made through doing YouTube, and I got to film videos, which is exactly what I love to do. After nearly a year with working with this company and flying out to LA and doing a whole bunch of really cool things, I decided to go out to LA for just the summer. But YouTube is really unpredictable, opportunities come up, things change, and now I am permanently out here in LA. It is honestly one of the craziest things ever because I would have never thought in a million years that I would be sitting in LA. And I guess the reason I decided to share my story with you guys today is because if there's one thing I want to prove from, I guess, my life, it's that you can do whatever you want to do if you try hard enough. Seriously, anything. Don't worry about money, don't worry about what's gonna happen, because if you're doing what you love, then everything will fall into place. And I know this video is probably really cheesy, but it's the truth. And I really genuinely hope that my YouTube story inspires you guys to be yourself and do what you love to do. So here's to 500K, and seriously, thank you guys so much for supporting me every single day. I can't thank you enough because honestly, I would be nowhere without every single one of you. I hope you guys liked this week's video. It was definitely a special one, and if you did, then make sure to give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys next Saturday, as always. Bye!